Hey ninjas, welcome back to the channel. Design Syndrome here. If you want to finally beat that perfectionism that stalls you and paralyzes you by learning new tools and perspective on design that will help you gain the confidence that you need, this is the place for you. So please hit that subscribe button and the little bell icon also so you don't miss any of the future videos of this channel. Back in my university days, we did everything by cutting things with scissors and pasting them all together, then scanning them and cutting them again and re-scanning them again. And so everything had this sort of grungy and noisy feel to it. So this effect has a really close seat next to my heart, and it's the noise graphics or the photocopy effect. Call it however you want. It's super useful for album art or merch design, a really overall cool tool to have in your arsenal to add really quick, like figurative meaning to your pieces and compositions. Right now, I will teach you a layer setup to make the effect live in a non-destructive way. I've also made a free texture pack that you can download from the links below with some cool patterns that we can add later to the effect, so please go download it right now. Okay, but before jumping into the tutorial, a quick word from today's sponsor.
Myself.
Spend less time on Google looking for that graphic, mockup, or amazing texture. In my asset store, you'll find a huge selection of free and paid graphic design assets to help you level up your designs. I want you all to experiment and play, to work faster and with more confidence, to deal with those feelings of doubt and fear, and just create. Be it with knowledge or with tools, I got you.
Use code SYNDROME15 to get 50% off in your order.
This helps the channel a lot, so thank you. Now moving on. Okay, time to get to it. Let's hop over to Photoshop. We have our file. You can do this really with any kind of like file setup. Let's just say we have this image, and I'm gonna show you with a quick layer setup how to turn something like this into something like this with just a few layers. Okay, so first thing we're gonna do, we're gonna make a really rough selection to give it that sort of like cutout feel, you know, like it's some sort of stamp or graphic. So let's just make like a really rough selection, like really stylized, you know, something like this works. And now we're gonna make a mask out of the image, clicking here in this button below the layers, and that's gonna make a mask. Now we're gonna go into the image thumbnail, and first we're gonna give it a border, you know, go to outer glow, because we want the border actually to have some sort of noise to it. We don't want it to be like just a straight line. So we're gonna go to outer glow, we're gonna give it a color black, noise like this. We're gonna adjust the spread and the size just to fit like whatever that it is that we want, right? But also, as this is a smart object layer, we can come back in and really tweak it to the final aesthetic that we want. But let's just make something like this. And also we're gonna give it like an inner glow with the same characteristics. I'm gonna make it black, set the blending mode. If you can't see the color, maybe it's on screen or in any other like additive blend mode that it's not gonna show the darker colors. So set it to multiply or normal, it's really the same. Let's make it less size, a bit more choke. Give it a little less size, something like this. And on the outer glow, a little less. And something like that, done. Now, okay, another thing we need to do with this is to kill the colors to make it black and white. So to do that, let's go to image, adjustments, hue and saturation. Let's get rid of the saturation. Now we're gonna add another layer to this. We're gonna clip it to the layer below. We're gonna do the pontigize effect that I showed you on the previous tutorial, in one of my previous tutorials. So to do that, let's do on this new layer that we created, let's go to fill. Fill it with 50% gray. And here, let's go to filter, pixelate, pontigize, and let's give it something a little larger this time around. So we can have like a even chunkier noise, you know, that will give it that little, that extra oomph, you know, to the graphic that's really distressed and really like punk, you know? So let's give it a 6. Or something like that, looks nice. Let's do again also the saturation for this. Image adjustments, hue and saturation. Let's kill the colors. Let's add to this a bit of blur. So let's go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Just a tiny bit, let's do 1. This is because when we add the layers on top of it to really mesh it all together, if the pointigize is too harsh, then you'll get like those harsh pixels. We don't really want that for this effect. So let's do this. set this layer to overlay. To this, now what we're going to do is we're going to add a levels, but we're going to do it in the layer levels. We're not going to do the levels below the pontigize effect, right? Because we want it to stack. So to do that, we're going to go to layer, new adjustment layer. I'm going to go here, levels. We're going to use previous layer here in the checkbox, so it clips to the one below. And here, we're going to create, like I already told you this in a previous tutorial, we're going to do like a soft threshold, you know? Like threshold does this. It brings the threshold back so much that you lose all the intermediate values. But we don't want to do that too much here. We're going to keep it a bit soft. So something like this. Of course, we can come back and readjust it, but this is an intermediate step. So let's leave it like this. And now another thing we can do is we're going to apply a curves layer between the first image and the pontigize, because this way we'll be able to sort of play a bit with the values of the original image to really get some crazier effects, you know? To do this here in the image, and we're going to do the same, but applying a curves layer. New adjustment layer, curves, use previous layer to make the clipping mask. And right now we can start to maybe see what happens, play a bit with the image. You can see you can start to make stuff like this. We are sort of half inverting the image, like in certain spots. We can play till we get something that sort of looks cool. Now let's use the textures that I made for this free pack. So to use them, here you have a couple of free paper textures. These are normal textures, you can use them however you like. But the cool thing are these patterns that I make. You see, their values are sort of mute. It's kind of 50% grade. And this is that way to be used in the overlay mode. For example, let's go with this one. Let's place it here over the image. Let's clip the mask. And now let's set this layer to overlay. And you can see how already is it starting to affect like the pontigize effect, and that texture is starting to come through in the sort of the threshold effect. And you can play here, maybe you bring it on top of the noise or below the noise, or maybe you bring it even below the curves. And you can start playing to see what look suits you better, right? Because we can maybe put it here over the image and below the curves. And let's see what happens if we play with it. You get some crazy textures, you know? Maybe something like that. And we can maybe come back into the image and we can move it because the effect is live. And you can get something like this, or let's move it on to the top. And then you can go back into the levels and play again with that. I'm gonna do a hard zoom in here because you see if we bring it the threshold, I close it all the way, you see you get these harsh pixels. But let's open it just a bit and we get something a bit more open and has like a softer gradation that makes it look a bit nicer in my opinion. You can even, if you have the like this noise, you can even shrink it more to get a finer noise, or you can make it larger, even chunkier noise, something like this. I really like it to play about that intermediate, you know? And another thing that's cool that we can do is, let's grab the image and add just a bit of blur to the original image. Because as you can see, like the full resolution of the original image is coming through, and it's not really like so accurate. Like if you have this like large chunks of noise, it's not really that accurate that the image should maintain its original like detail and resolution. So it's cool like to actually lose a bit of that sharpness in the original image. It looks kind of cool because it's more cohesive with the idea of the noise, you know. this sort of punk aesthetic. It's break status quo, you know, like go against the ultra realism, hyper resolution. It's this is all about the error, the mistake, and to make it like it's breaking, like you're breaking something. So the uglier the better, or the more imperfect the better. That goes aligns so well with the message that I'm trying to portray with my pieces also. You can even, as the texture that we imported, the one here, it's a smart object. We can even do image adjustments. Remember, when you do image adjustments, the adjustments are being applied to the layer itself. If the layer is a smart object, then it will apply to the smart object and you'll be able to change it later. But if it's not, then it's just gonna apply destructively, you know. Image adjustments, curves. And here we can play only with the curves of the texture, you know. Here, start to play with it. Look at that. And like this, you get a really crazy, you know, really unique feel into your threshold graphics. For example, let's get rid of this layer now and let's bring another one of the ones that I did. For example, this one, it's really trippy. This one is the one that I used for the Maria Tokar collab. Let's do a clipping mask, set it to, again, overlay. Something like this, and again, let's do an image adjustments, curves, and let's play a bit with these curves. Let's see what we can come up. Come on, look at that. And you see, you can even crisscross, for example, this happened here. This was a mistake. I did this by mistake, like having the two together, like that wasn't intended. And you can really start to play, like mixing and mashing texture together or within the levels adjustment layer and setting all in the middle as overlay. Or maybe try with different methods to see what the ones that you get. I always encourage you to always explore and play and play really with the thing that you see on the tutorials. Don't just mindlessly like follow them to the T, like really get in there and playing. That's the way you start to really know the software, so it doesn't become a limitation and actually you start experimenting and come up with your own solutions to these kinds of effects. Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab everything that we did here and we're gonna place this into a group. Let's say we are working with a background, yeah? This red background. And we really want to make it, let's make it orange, something like this. We want to make it orange and we want to get rid of it, but we don't want to do the multiply thing, right? We don't want to do the multiply thing because maybe then after we start working with another graphic and we just want to be able to composite them in ways that we like. This is cool, like the white background looks really cool, but I'm going to show you this real quick. As you can see here, we have black and white information for the pixels. And one thing we can do here is we can go to the original layer. Let's go into the blending mode. And this is to make it transparent. To make it transparent here, the blend if section is showing you like the here, as all the nodes are in the extremes, is showing you the full range of values of this image. But if you see, if I bring this white node here, as soon as I move it just a tiny bit, it's because it's saying that that part in the range of highlights, it's not gonna show, it's not gonna blend to the layer below. So if I bring it here, you see how the pure white disappears, but we still have some pixels that are sort of grayish. They are not pure white. We have a couple of pixels that are not pure white that are still showing. So if we break the node here, pressing Alt, and we move it just around to the other side, we can see how we can make the software like blend the intermediate like values. So we can start really playing here and get rid of the white in a procedural way. Something like this. You can even make it, let's go again. And as soon as all the white sort of disappears, like that, then you break the node with Alt and you bring it even more. And there you have all the gray and everything's perfect. And this is live, you know? And just like this, your Norris graphics ready to go. So yeah, that's almost it. Now I'm gonna show you real quick the action pack because it comes with an action to do this instantly. I'm gonna show you right now how to use it. Let's get rid of this image. Let's bring a new stock image. Grab this image, for example, this, and let's make a selection. You can even make it with a rectangle like this, but I think it looks better when we do the contour shape selection. It's gonna select the subject. There, it's sort of selected correctly. So let's add the parts that are missing. We're in the selection, and now we go here, and here's like the action pack. To import it, you just go to here, load action. You browse the file that you downloaded and you have it here. You just double click and it's going to load and you'll have it here. And from here, you have here the two actions, one to recolor your artwork after the fact. Here's the action. First, you need to make the selection. And once you've done it, you go here, you press play. And there you have it. Just like that instant noise setup, you have all here the layers that we set up at the beginning. You just drop in the new textures or whatever you want to do. You play with it, but you have it here in a real simple and quick way, you know? And once you have this and you have the final graphic that you want, there is another action to change the color. You just go into the group layer, you press this action, and it's gonna blend it all together and make it a mask of a solid color layer. This way you can double click and change the color, and again, keep playing with it. You keep also the original behind it, so you can go back and edit it if you want. So this way, you see, we can start to make compositions sort of like this, and making whatever designs that we want, you can start to composite your pieces together. Oh, and almost forgot one of the final steps. Let's get back to this one, the one that we were editing. Let's get rid of this because it's getting in the way. Let's get back to this graphic. Sorry, I forgot this part. We have the group really with our noise graphic. We can grab a texture, any texture. This is from the free texture pack. You can download it from the store. Let's just grab this texture, whatever. What we're gonna do now, we're gonna stretch the layer so it covers the entire thing. We can select all. We're gonna copy. We're gonna deselect. We can get rid of this. And now we're gonna go into to this group. We're gonna make a mask. Press Alt click on the mask thumbnail here. And we're gonna open the mask edition tool. And here we're just gonna paste in place. To paste in place is Control Shift B. And there it plays the texture, you know, as a mask. And you can see here how the texture is sort of applying and not showing the graphic in those parts that we have black in the mask. So now we can, while we're in the mask, we can, with the mask selected, we can edit that texture that we just imported. And to do that, let's do image, adjustments, curves. And here we are playing with the texture that we applied to the mask, right? So we can start adding another dimension of texture to the noise graphic. And again, playing with the curves. In the texture, we can get something like this. And to really close it, we bring another texture on top. You already know how it is. Play a bit with the fill, so it's not that harsh. Amazing texture, really easy to use, and amazing tool to add to your arsenal. That was it, guys. Hope you liked it and hopefully learned something. If you did, please consider subscribing or leaving a comment or a like. It helps the channel a lot. And don't forget to please go to my site and download any of the free graphic design assets that I have for you. There are also the full paid packs or maybe some prints. You can access everything from the links below. And again, guys, really thank you for watching. I hope to see you in the next video. And remember, fuck peace, wish you conflict.